We are live on the floor of the 2014 Global Real Estate Summit, and I'm here with Debra Cafaro, Chairman and CEO of Ventas, who just participated on a lively panel titled Responding to the New Drivers of Real Estate. And Deb, I'm going to cut to the chase. In DLA Piper's 2014 State of the Market survey, and for 2 years running now, we found that survey respondents have told us that healthcare assets, such as hospitals, medical office buildings, and assisted living facilities, are the most attractive investment class for the coming year, followed by multifamily and industrial. So you tell me, why does healthcare continue to be such a strong and well-positioned asset class?
Well, you're right. Healthcare has really become a primary asset class within real estate. And I think of three things for the reason. Demographics, I would say policy trends, and also reliable cash flow growth. And those are three things that we really prize in real estate. The first, demographics, is really demand. The over 75 population is growing at 6 times the rate of the average U.S. population. Mm-hmm. We have the 79 million baby boomers who started becoming Medicare eligible in 2011. Those give our assets tremendous demand. And so people like demand. Secondly, policy. We have the Affordable Care Act.
Right.
25 million people should be coming into our healthcare system more in a regular way, and that should increase utilization for our medical office buildings, in addition to the baby boomers, which also helps to increase demand for our medical office buildings. And also, there is a huge trend in the U.S. toward treating people in the lowest cost, most clinically appropriate settings,
right,
which tend to be skilled nursing assets, medical office buildings, and we are right at Main and Main in terms of those trends. And the last is senior living and other healthcare assets perform the absolute best of any real estate asset class during the financial crisis and recession, and that's because they are demographically driven and need-based. And so the demand is inelastic. And so because of the performance, people see very protected downside and good growth characteristics, which is very consistent with basically a core real estate asset class. So that's why people love healthcare and senior living assets, in my opinion.
Okay, so the healthcare sector is very well positioned. What is Ventas' strategy moving forward? I know when we talked a year ago, things were going very well.
Yes.
You guys were getting very good deals.
Yes.
We were talking about the long-term growth and return for shareholders.
Yes.
But from this point moving forward, what is your strategy to continue to capitalize on the opportunities that you just described?
Yeah. I mean, at Ventas, we are focused on delivering consistent, superior return to shareholders, and we do three things. So first of all, we have to raise capital efficiently and effectively, and we continue to do that and work on that liability side of the balance sheet to fix long-term rates, which are still at exceedingly low levels.
Mm-hmm.
We have to invest wisely and accretively, and we continue to see tremendous opportunities in the $1 trillion domestic healthcare market, which is fragmented, it is under-owned in public hands, and it's exceedingly dynamic, and lots of consolidation, so lots of investment opportunities. And we have to manage our assets well, and we continue to focus really on driving same-store growth. And the last item I would mention is that Ventas has started to really build an international footprint. And so as of next year, we think that 5% of our net operating income will come from assets outside the U.S. And we expect those activities to continue, which give us greater opportunities for continued growth and diversification.
Okay, great. Again, that was Debra Cafaro, Chairman and CEO of Ventas, Inc. Debra, thank you.
Great to be here with you. Thank you.